I love bike fishing and I'm always looking for the perfect solution to carry a fly rod on the bicycle. In this video, I'm going to review this First Cast rod by the brand Rare Gear. Is this the perfect travel slash bike fishing rod out there on the market? Find out in this video. Welcome back, Pathless Peddlers. And if you're new to the channel, if you're into the non-competitive side of cycling, riding your bikes for fun, riding party pace, you have found your people, hit that subscribe button. So I've been riding and fishing with this rod for the last couple of weeks, taking it on short bike trips, catching some fish on it, and I feel like I've finally got a sense of the rod and can share my opinions with you guys. But before I get into it, I do want to make the point that fish actually don't care what you're fishing with, what brand you're fishing with, whether it's Western or Tenkara. It's more about presentation. Over the past decade, I've fished with both Western rods and Tenkara rods and can see the value in both. And that is one reason that I got really interested in this one, because it does promise to combine the Western fly fishing experience but have the packability of a Tenkara rod. This is the 4-weight version of their First Cast rod, and what you see is what you get. You get this telescoping rod. It comes with an aluminum reel. Also comes complete with a weight forward fly line, tapered leader, small fly box, and this handy neoprene case. Pretty much out of the box, you have almost everything you need to fish except a fly, you know, the hemostats, nippers, it's kind of those basic tools and your fishing license, but pretty much a complete package. Rare Gear sells two versions of this rod. This is the 4-weight. There's also a larger 6-weight version. So everything you see here costs $279. And I know for some that may sound a little bit on the steep side, but it's actually par for course with a traditional Western fly fishing setup. Typically a rod will cost you anywhere from $150 to $200 to sky's the limit. Factor in a reel, that's probably another $50 to $100. And then the line itself, that could be upwards of $100. So it's actually pretty good value, or at least par for a beginner fly fishing setup. The rod in its collapsed form measures about 19 inches and weighs about 10 ounces. So the perfect size to fit in a large pannier. If you ride a big enough bike, you can actually fit this in a frame bag, which I think is pretty cool. One thing you'll notice about this rod is it has no line guide. So typically a fly rod or even a spinner rod, they have these little metal guides to run the line through, and this does not have that. So you'll notice here, it does have one kind of ferrule slash guide at the very tip. And on top of the handle, there is a stripping guide, or a hole rather, which the line runs through and goes through the center of the rod. So I found that in use, it's actually pretty quick to deploy and it fulfills on that promise. Basically, you would unwind some of your tippet here and your fly line, and then slowly expand the rod. There is kind of a specific order of operations. It's not quite like a Tenkara rod where you start from the smallest section and work your way backwards. With the Rare rod, you actually want to expand the second to largest section first and then work from the tip backward. So it takes a little bit of getting used to in setting it up and breaking it down, especially if you're already familiar with Tenkara rods. It's not exactly the same, but it's pretty close. It's close enough. Rare Gear also has a YouTube channel that kind of goes more in depth, so I'm going to direct you to that if you want more specific instructions. So how does it cast and does it catch fish? Well, I've been using this rod for the last couple weeks and I've tried various types of flies on there, from small dries to bigger hoppers to hopper droppers to indicator rigs. At one point I had a big fluffy dry fly and was suspending two nymphs, and the rod was able to cast all those systems. The fly line itself is supposedly a 4-weight, and I feel like that's pretty accurate. Definitely geared a little bit more towards dry fly fishing, although you can do some weighted nymphs and stuff, but I think it performs best without any weight. In terms of casting, this is where things get a little bit interesting. It's not quite as supple as a fiberglass rod or even a really long Tenkara rod, but it's not as quick action as a fast action fly rod. So it falls somewhere in between. Generally, I would say that this wants a slower casting cadence and also benefits from a more open loop cast. So not super quick and tight, but something a little bit slower, something a little bit more open to get the fly line out there. Perhaps the biggest thing I noticed when compared to a traditional packable Western fly rod is that this rod doesn't shoot line quite as well. And part of that is because of the internal routing, the lack of the external guides. That just provides a little bit more friction than is necessary to really bomb cast out there. So yes, you can do maneuvers like a double haul and it will shoot out a little bit of line, but you're not gonna be, you know, casting those 100-foot casts with this rod. That said, most fish are caught in fairly close in distances. So 30 feet, 20 feet, even 15 feet, this rod will do fine. So you're not gonna win any casting competitions, but you know, in tight fishy quarters, you'll be able to catch the fish. So what are the pros and cons, and do I recommend this rod? The first big pro is that it's collapsible. This thing is super quick to deploy and break down. The first day I took it out in the water, there were actually some other anglers walking towards the same piece of water, and I was able to walk and undo the rod and get to that water first. I think because it is easy to set up and collapse, it does make an ideal bike fishing rod, especially on those trips where you're kind of probing the water and want to see if there are any fish where you think they are. This makes it relatively quick and simple to do. Another big pro is, although it's kind of a funky design with the internal routing, if you will, it is pretty capable. I mean, you can fish small dries, big dries, hopper dropper setups, indicator rigs, all that stuff, and it works, albeit at shorter distances than, you know, a full-on Western rig. But in terms of what it's capable of, this can do a lot more than you think. So what are the cons of this rod? You know, the biggest con is going to be the higher friction because of the design that limits you in terms of, you know, the distance of your casting, as well as the ability to shoot line. And it's also a little bit stickier when you're trying to mend, so you'll disrupt your fly a little bit more. That's probably one of the bigger downsides. Not to say that you can't mend, but it definitely takes more deliberate action to do. Another con is when fishing shorter distances, I found that the line has a tendency to go into the rod. And when you just have the leader or tippet out there, again, there's just enough friction where you can't just flick the line out. I usually have to set the rod down and manually pull out some fly line so it starts to load the rod. The final con is the casting feedback. It's not quite as supple as a glass rod or a Tenkar rod. So I feel if you're an absolute beginner, it's gonna be a little bit more difficult to sense when the rod is fully loaded. That's not to say that you couldn't learn on this, but there would be better rods to kind of get a sense of the cadence of casting. So what do I think of this rod in general? I think this rod makes a good tool rod. It'll catch fish. It might not have the best overall casting experience, especially when compared to a bamboo rod or a fiberglass rod or something that's really long and supple. It's not the most pleasurable rod to cast, but it will get the job done. It will put the fly where you want it to, and it will catch you fish. I think because of this, it does have a little bit more of a steeper learning curve, especially if you're starting from scratch. This probably wouldn't be the best rod to learn on, but if you are, say, a beginner intermediate or intermediate or experienced angler, and you already have the dynamics of casting down, then this makes a great travel rod, something to leave in your truck, to leave in the backpack, to take with you on those scouting expeditions, on a hike or on a bike ride. So it's an interesting rod. I don't think it should be your first fly rod or only fly rod, but it is a great tool rod for when you want something small, easy, and quick to deploy, let's say on a hike or, of course, on a bike fishing trip. So that's what I think. Let me know what you think. Have any of you guys tried rods from Rare Gear? Let me know your opinions below. And I'd be curious, what do you guys fish with? Are you hardcore Tenkara fan? Or do you bring a Western rod with you on your bikepacking trips? Let me know in the comments below. If you have any questions, again, leave those in the comments. I'll be sure to answer them. And as always, keep the supple side down.